I think it just turned on. Oh, you're totally fine.
At the same time that I'm doing this, waiting for my daughter. I remember when she was born, my first baby, of course, and that the first day, that the first time that the doctor, you know, show us Katie, it was a tremendous joy in my heart and my wife, of course, to have this beautiful daughter. And she was born in Cartagena. I'm from the Caribbean. And she loved the ocean. She loved to go to the beach. She loved to enjoy the shell of and the ocean. And so that's what the theme is, mostly like Caribbean theme, because she was born in that area. So she's enjoying this moment right now. So Tony, it seemed like I just met you yesterday. Really, I met you yesterday. Tony, you know, really, I remember Tiketi was about to go to the East, about 6 months ago, and she was doing all the work that she was supposed to have a job in the East, and my wife and me were praying, Lord, you have to do something drastic. We don't want our daughter to go to the East. And you really, really got hear our prayers, because it was like in a week. Hallelujah. So, praise God. Tony, we love you, and we welcome you in our home. Praise the Lord. First of all, I want to give you my advice as a father, and then I'm going to give you my advice as a minister. And as a father, of course, I have a wife, of course, and I have three children. Katie's one of them, and five grandchildren, which I love so much. And I thank God for the 35 years that I have with my wife. As a father, we raise our children in the fear of God. We did our best, you know. It wasn't easy, but I know that you have a son, and Katie has a son too, and you are already a father, and you are already a mother. But continue, you know, doing your work as a father, as a mother, and God will bless you. And if there's another baby coming later, also bless them too. Amen? Praise the Lord. But now as a ministry, you know, as a ministry, I really feel that the first thing is you need to dedicate this home to God. You know, this life is supposed to be given to the Lord. And this relationship is supposed to be built upon the foundation of love and love alone. I know that this word is kind of like, you know, but what is love really? And when I think about love, we're going to read something about that. Is 1 Corinthians 13 says that love is kind, love is patient, love, you know, suffers everything. And one of the things that I like about love is that he is kind, and love endures all things. And it's going to come times in your life that it's not going to be easy. But remember that because you love each other, you can make it. You can do it. So there's a word that I have been thinking about it, being that we are from the Caribbean, the pirates of the Caribbean, you know, there's a lot of pirates that came in our country. And the word treasure comes to my mind. And Katie's a treasure for us. She's a special daughter. She has gone through a lot, you too. And the Lord has shaped Katie in a special way. And the word treasure, I would like to tell you a few things about it. The T stand for time, you know. Take time for each other. You know, when you take care of a garden, you know, you have to make sure that you put water on those flowers, make sure that you spend time taking the weeds out, you know, so that garden can be beautiful. I want you to spend time with each other, you know. This life is too busy, and people don't take care of each other because there's so much stuff going on that we forget that moment. So always think about treasure and the T for time. You know, because you need each other. I know that you have children, but it's important for you to spend time with each other. That's what love is going to be strong every time that you spend time with each other and consider each other and water each other with love in those times. The other letter is red, it's R, it's respect. You know, and I know that already. Tony, I mean, that's amazing. The way that you respect my daughter, I'm grateful to the Lord and to you, and Kathy too, how respect you. But that word respect is important in marriage, you know. Don't lose that, you know. Even though you will be very familiar to each other, and still that respect has to remain there, because that's going to keep you strong. And also, it will be passed on to the children. They will see that. The word E, to edify. So mean encouraging each other, you know, inspire each other. You know, sometimes we get old in marriage, seems like there's not, the fire's not there. But my encouragement to you is to encourage each other, to edify each other, and to inspire. I know there's some things that Tony would like to do, and maybe he hasn't been able to do. Maybe encourage him, inspire him, and encourage him to do that. And vice versa, Tony, there's things that Katie wants to do in life, and you are here to inspire her and to encourage her to do these, those things. So the word S is for seek. Seek, put God first in everything. You know, this is the best part for me of the word treasure. Because if we don't seek God, He is the author of relationship. He's the author of marriage. And He's the only one that knows your future. And He knows what is ahead of you. So if you go to Him, I'm sure that He's going to share with you and reveal to you what is it that you need. So put God first in your life. I know. My wife knows. And that's a blessing in our life. The word you, for unite. When trials come, unite, you know. Build a strong front. That's the key. There's, I mean, marriage is not just a lot of roses. It's beautiful right now. We all look beautiful here. But it's going to come times, the trials are going to come, difficult is going to come, the test is going to come. But that's why you have to unite together and build a strong front to face anything that comes your way, and you will be successful. The R is for rest. Just relax. Just take time. You know, I know that the society is always running and pressuring you, but just, you know, you need to take that moment just to relax and to enjoy each other. The E, again, embrace. Each other, embrace each other each day in hope. And I'm sure that, Katie, you love Cartagena, and you love to go in the beach and check the little things in the ocean. And that's what I brought the word treasure, because that's what you love. You are a treasure, Katie. You know, I love you, and I love you. And we know, Tony, that we give you a treasure. And I know that the time that I met you, I know that Katie is also getting a special treasure. And I would like to give you my blessings. And I want you to come forward over here, please. And I want to pray for you right now. Father, I thank you so much for the blessing that we have to be here with my daughter and my son-in-law, Father, Lord, and this opportunity that I have to bless them in this day of their life, Father, a special day that they have, Father. I thank you so much, oh God, that for me that's a privilege that you will use me, Father, to give the blessing to my own daughter and to my future son-in-law, Father. So right now, Lord, I call upon the presence of the Holy Spirit. He's the only one that knows about unity. He's the only one that knows about becoming one. And that's why we call upon His presence at this very moment. Because in a mysterious way, Father, we don't see it. We just are doing it in the physical realm over here. But in the spiritual realm, we know that this union is happening also. So Holy Ghost, we pray for the seal of your love, the seal of your power, the seal of your unity, Antoni and Katie, today. Thank you so much, God, for blessing them and for bringing them together. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Wow. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 through 8 and 13. My friends, love is patient. Love is kind and is not jealous. Love does not brag and is not arrogant. It does not act unbecoming. It does not seek its own. It is not provoked. It does not take into account a wrong suffering. It does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoice with the truth. Bears all things, believes in all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. But if there are gifts of prophecy, they will be done away. If there are tongues, they will cease. If there is knowledge, it will be done away. But not faith. Hope, love, Abide these three. But the greatest of these is love. I love you, God.
Praise the Lord. Will you face each other, please? At this moment, you're going to take a vow. Tony, you take Katie to be your wife, and you promised before God, this witness, and especially me. To love, honor, to serve her in sickness and in health, to be true and loyal to her as long as you both shall live. Good. Katie, my dear daughter, will you take Tony to be your husband? And will you promise before God and these witnesses to love, honor, to serve him in sickness and in health, to be true and loyal to him as long as you both shall live?